Hey guys, it's Jim. Thanks for being here. You know, sometime I was doing a live demonstration at Your Pie Pizza in Lumberton, and Jane was recording it on Facebook Live. And I was just at the point where I was dabbing in these black silhouetted foliage when it started raining. Yep, I got rained out. Can you
believe it?
Anyways, we packed it up, went inside. Had a paint party scheduled that evening, so we went ahead and did that, and it was a good night. But what I want to do is I want to finish this painting in my studio so we can get these foliage, the black silhouette foliage, done and get some tree trunks in there and get squared away, right? It's nothing worse than a half-finished painting.
Cool.
Well, I downloaded the footage from Facebook Live, and I'm going to show that real quick. And then I'm going to show the footage I'm going to record here right now of me finishing it. And then we'll just go from there. All right? So, let's do this. Hey guys, okay, we're at Your Pie Pizza in Lumberton. You can hear me okay? Had some issues with the setup, just using my phone, see how this goes, I don't know. I want to do a demonstration on acrylic painting. Basically, I was going to do an autumn scene, but I walked across the computer yesterday and I saw a screensaver that I just had to paint. There's a night sky, had like a moon here, had a glow coming from light to dark, right? See the canvas okay to me? It had some clouds and there's some trees silhouetted in front of it. It was a night scene with stars. It had like three colors, black, white, and blue. I still wanted to do an autumn scene with oranges and yellows and stuff. So why not do the same painting but change the color scheme up? So I want to have yellow instead of white, blue and black. I'm going to have yellow. Then maybe an orange and go into red, some brown, get some warm colors in there, stick some clouds in front of that moon, put some silhouettes of some leaves and stuff here. We'll have a little bit of fun here, okay? Alright. It's pretty warm out here. I'm outside and your acrylic dries fast. Okay? That's her. Okay, that's it. My camera person. Jane's sitting down, she's holding the camera. Can I get a good in? Right?
Yeah.
Anyways, it's real warm outside. Nice. Kinda hot. So and acrylic dries super fast. And so it's good to do an underpainting first to seal the pores of the canvas so that it'll slow down the drying time, right? So I pre-painted the, what we can call the undercoat, right? So I'll pop this off. Right. And we'll start with this. Alright. Here it goes. Turn this way. Alright, okay. Earlier today I just put in some color. I wanted light to dark, so I put light here and just made it darker as I went across. You notice there's something sitting right here? I went ahead and cut out a crescent moon out of a piece of contact paper. Stuck it on before I started painting. Just painting over it. That way that shape would be there when I take it off. I like shortcuts. Work smart, not hard, right? Okay. So first we're going to do is I'm going to put more yellow here and I'm going to work it across and try to smooth it over as best I can, okay? Start with some yellow. And I'm going to pour the paint as I go along when I need it because it's so warm out here, the paint will get tacky and it'll dry fast. Alright.
white.
And it's not in here, but I'm gonna throw in some jack-o'-lantern orange. Burnt sienna. I want to keep it dark right there. Since, oh, let me tell you the differences between paint night or paint parties and workshops. Our paint parties, $35 here at York Pizza. We use craft paint like this to keep the prices down, minimal tools. It's a 2-hour event, so we've got to keep the paintings not real simplistic, but we've got to be done within 2 hours. We offer workshops, it's like on demand, where we use the more expensive tube paint and the palette knives. It's more advanced, more about technique and everything, still a lot of fun. Those are generally $60. Check out our website, crystalfresco.gymdo.com, and you can read all about it. But anyways, I don't have any burnt sienna. As a craft, I'm going ahead and use it out of the tube. And the only tools I'm using are these 1.5-inch chip brushes and a script liner. That's it. Okay. Oh. And a sponge for the trees and stuff. I'm using a paper plate as a palette. I'm going to load up my brush with this yellow. I'm going to start here and work my way this way. So it's going to be super bright. Work over that. I'm working fast because it is warm and paint's drying super quick, but with this technique, you can do that. Plus, if you have to, you get yourself a little squirt bottle like this, or a spritzer. Just gotta like put a fine mist over it. Don't soak it, just a fine mist. That helps the paint spread. Without cleaning the brush, I'm going straight to this orange, jack-o'-lantern orange. I'm going to work it right into that yellow. It's kind of blend the two together. From here to here, you want it blended the best you can. A lot of paint. Alright. Up here. I know. You warm it up, put some red there. Deep red. Clean the brush again, load it with red. Alright, work it up here. That's a pop red, huh? Be careful where you have that crescent moon, you don't want to flip it over and get paint underneath it, so you kind of like pull away from it with your pink strokes. Alright. Here, just kind of clean your brush a little bit, get all the excess off. Pick up some more of that orange right underneath it and kind of like blend them together. That warmed it up. It sure did. Go little more spritz. Go back into the orange. I'm going into the burnt sienna, which is a warm brown. Back in with a little bit of red wood, it's warming up even more. It should look almost like a rust color or a burgundy. All right, so I'm going up here with that. Yeah, that's a burgundy color. Working through the red and blend them together. Come up here, pick up more brown. Alright. So now we have a gradation from light to dark. I'm not even going to clean that brush, I just dropped it in the water to keep it wet so it don't dry. Pick it up another one. I'm going to work some white in it. To do that, I'm going to have to re-wet this with yellow. Yeah, this is dry. It's all dry right now. So I'm gonna re-wet this with yellow. Hey, how you doing?
I'm
doing great. It's out here painting, man. I'm just gonna brighten that up a little bit right here. Right down there. So we got the light and dark.
Alright.
Now the next step, we should let it dry really, but I can work over it because you had that underpainting. If you worked into it right now while it's wet, and you didn't do that underpainting, this layer would just get pulled off from the canvas. You get all that white canvas underneath. Now if this does get pulled off because it's still kind of tacky as it dries, there's that underpainting to keep it from getting all messed up. Before I do that, I want to take this moon off. Hopefully we'll see how it comes out. Oh, I need a palette knife. Hold on. Get my palette knife. There you go. Little palette knife I got. In fact, this is a Bill Alexander knife. I've had it for years. Got this in the 90s. I think. I want to peel this off. Hopefully it doesn't take. Hopefully it'll be nice and clean. Ta-da! Oh, that's nice and bright. Alright, we got a little crystal moon. Oh, nice and bright and everything. I'm going to put some clouds in here next, okay? And when it's still kind of tacky, that's okay. I'm going to pick up a brush. A flat brush. Give me a second. Got to grab it. Solo momento. Pito. Work. This is a half inch flat brush, synthetic. What I'm going to do is we need to put some shadows in here for the clouds to sit on. He's got this, the sun is way over here and it's just lighting this up. So we're going to put some shadows over there, right? So we'll pick up some of that burnt sienna, like that little brown I got here, a little bit of white.
You got one person watching.
Awesome. I'm going to pick up some brown. Alright. So I'm just going to just put a couple marks like this right here. Just kind of dancing on it. Down the bottom. Just kind of touch it with a finger. lighten it up as you go down. It's getting closer to the... Now lighten up as you go. Yeah, little clouds and stuff. Right. Down here, it's just kind of scrubbing. You like wipe the brush off. And with a kind of a wet brush, you just come down to the bottom part, kind of scrub it, stretch it out. Right at the bottom, and just a hair bit of water to help move it. There you go. Alright. Something like that. Yeah. Alright. Then I'm going to pick up some white, just a little bit of yellow. White and yellow, because the white will make the yellow opaque. Yellow is super transparent with this, these acrylics. The little white bit makes it opaque, and so it'll show better. All right, got the light coming this way, so we want the highlight clouds to be on the bottom side, because the light's coming this way, right? Right here on the bottom, start just tapping like this little highlight stuff here, little stringy stuff right here at the bottom. Kind of a Halloween type. Kind of rub it, kind of push it back. Stain right there. I want to cover this right here, so I'm going to put some dark right there. A little bit of dark up here as well, so it's kind of pulled across. And then put some more of that yellow highlight. Something like that. I should like push it back a little bit. Alright? Yeah. If you like, you can like soften this edge here, because you want this edge to be fairly sharp. This edge you want to kind of soften because the light's going around it, right? So if you take in some of that burnt here. Just a little bit of it, so you want to like dry brush it. So I'm just going to go right over this edge and just kind of like soften it. Thank you. Next thing we're going to do is the foliage. The foreground trees that are silhouetted against all this bright color. Because you needed some good contrast, so you need that background to be really bright. Alright? And we're going to use the sponge. Alright? Because you want to create texture. And with this craft paint, you just can't create good texture. You can with the toothpaste, because it's thicker, especially the thick body stuff. And so using acrylic, you can use a sponge. That one. Take my sponge, I'm going to kind of fold it over like that, so it's like a little ball. Alright? Then I'm going to tap it to this black, and then tap it onto the plate. You want to dial that excess off, so you got like this, a little bit like that, and start tapping in some foliage. Like there's something like, I remember this one right there. So I gotta close this down. This water is hitting my canvas and it is coming down. We'll do this again at 6 o'clock. We're painting inside. Paint night. Be there, be square. Signing off. Bye.
Okay. Here we got our 12 by 16 canvas. And 12 by 16. We've already done the sky. Then we got the moon, which was a cool way to do it. We used contact paper, cut it out, and stuck it on there. Then after we painted over it, peeled it right off. Did the trick. Laid in some clouds, and now we're working on this foliage area. And what I used for that was a sponge. Right? Got this little sponge here. It's one of the sea sponges. With acrylics, really great for getting all these little, all that texture for like leaves and stuff. All right, but first it's all hard and dry and brittle. We want to wet it down first, so we stick it in the water. This is acrylic. All right, and that way the sponge becomes all nice and bendable, and you can like turn it. Right, so I'll put that down for a minute. We're just using black right now for this silhouette. I'm just using this craft paint. I got these little bowls like this. I use it for white previously. Once you use it, don't throw them away. Keep using it because it dries fast. Next time you paint, you know, you pull it out and just paint right over it, you know. Just make the paint last. Absolutely. Make your tools last. All right. Anyways, we've got some black paint in here. We get this sponge and you kind of fold it over to like a little ball. I don't know if you see that, like that. Kind of like a little ball like that. You got all these little ridges and holes and stuff. All right. Then you pick up your little palette or bowl and just tap the black into it. Just tap, tap, tap. And you don't want it soaked in it. You just enough to, you know, you dab it. You make sure it stays folded over. All right, you dab it like so, and you go to the side, and you kind of dab all the excess off, so it's almost like a dry brush, right? Then we went in here and we just created some little foliage areas, little textures, right? Down here in the corner, I really want it dark. This tip keeps flipping over. Stay. All right, pick up some more of that black. So I'm coming down here on the bottom, and I really want this bottom to be pretty covered. You will get paint on your fingers, guaranteed. All right, over here, hit this corner. And you know, I have the paint wrapped around it. So I'll go ahead and cover the side right here. Pick some more paint. Right, maybe on the bottom. Just kind of get it all worked in there. And the side right here. Same thing over here. Right. Okay. Maybe we got one right here, all by his lonesome. Needed something there. Something like that. Okay? Then I just drop that sponge into the water, swish it around. Squeeze excess. Excuse my arm. Maybe next time I need to move this on the other side. All right, we're done with that. Now what we're going to do next, we're going to lay in these little tree trunks and stuff. Some limbs, you know, they're all coming out and kind of like zigzagged and everything. So you get us like either a script liner or a round brush, whatever you got. But it should be like round. I don't know if you can see that, but yeah. You get a round brush or a script liner. I like these script liners. Wet it real good, and that black paint you had, you want to wet it down real good. So it's not super thin, but it's thin enough to where it'll flow off your brush easier, right? And you turn your brush and you spin it and get all loaded up. Alright. So when you create some little limbs and stuff. Like this one right here, I just laid in. This looks like a perfect place for a tree, right? Yeah, just keep this on the side. Here we go. So I'm going to come out from here, from the very bottom, and I'm just going to go, just kind of work it up. Then I'm going to stop, move to the side, and stop. Then up, stop, up. From here, maybe he just comes out from there, up to side. Maybe that way. And don't do it one long stroke. It's best if you do like just a short stroke. Like a line, then change the angle, line, change the angle, line. And that way you get it. And then get those little twig things going. Maybe once right here. It's coming up like so. make those all rights? Okay. We got one maybe coming up this way. Just come around. And he's got, and here's this one. In fact, this one don't have any limbs on or leaves or nothing on it. I'm going to put quite a few that just comes out and just, you know, they're not dead. It's just, this looks more like a fall painting. So we're going to have a lot of these that are just bare, you know. When you come in, when you come down here in the bottom, go ahead and make it this trunk thicker. Right, just kind of come up, thicken it, and then as you go up, make sure it gets thinner. There's like one right here. Right, loading up the brush after every stroke, just about. That one's coming off the canvas. Alright. Alright. I'm really trying to break myself from saying alright all the time. It's difficult. Okay. Here's another one here. Just these little twigs. I think I need a little bit more paint. There we go. Squeeze. Let's load it back up. Make sure it's all nice and wet. Alright, and as you're moving this brush up, you can kind of spin the brush a little bit and it'll, and the paint will flow easier, I believe, off there, you know. Anyways, I'm gonna make this trunk kind of thicker over here. Alright. Let me see. And maybe this one comes up like so. Yeah, look, I'm doing these little lines right here. See this little knot right there? I could pull something off of that. Right, and maybe something's coming here. Just little things coming out. Like so. Here's one that's just a little twig maybe. This one here is maybe coming off the side. This one coming up with it, and maybe even going past it. Something like that. Bring it around here, around there, around everywhere. You see. And maybe down under here is some little smaller ones, little limbs or little twigs or something coming out of the ground. Go ahead and cross them up if you want. Like, we got these little leafy, grassy things coming out. Maybe pull it up. Let's go whoop. Something like that. There's one here on this side, maybe. Stop. See, I'm going, then stop. Come up, stop, up, stop, up. There's one there. This coming around here. Bringing this around toward the corner. And then maybe there's this one right here coming up. You can go down or up. I personally tend to go from the bottom up. You know, I think it's easier that way. Alright. Some little grassy things poking out. So it gives it some character. Now, you don't want to put too many of these, right? You know? It's like we're coming out of the woods. I still got my shades on too, so it's not too bad. You know the story about my shades, right? Why am I wearing shades? Well, it's some time ago, I had cataract surgery. Everything turned white. I lost my sight. I couldn't see. But anyways, I had cataract surgery. And after that, there was side effects. One is light kills me. Right? So I'm looking at this light behind the camera. And so I'm like, ah, it's killing me. Another thing is I have excessive eye pressure. And so my eyes are just, I mean, you can just feel the pressure all the time. And so I'm always squinting and they're sore. And they, it looks like I'm stoned 24 hours a, you know, a day. even when I'm sleeping. but anyways, that's why I'm wearing shades. I would take them off sometimes when I paint because I'm looking away, but I keep turning toward the camera. And I've, right now, it's working. I'm not doing any, a lot of detail right now. And I can see well enough, you know, through these glasses. That light is pretty bright. Up here, you can have like a little limb coming out. Something like that. Right? Give some little character. It's coming out of this this clump right here. And, well, you know, that didn't take long. But yeah, we got rained out. Between then and now, oh, I gotta show you this. Between then and now, I pulled out this canvas. It was stored, you know, and there was a big dimple in it. Like it was something was pressing against the back, so I had a big dimple. In fact, you kind of still see it, but it's practically gone. If that ever happens to you, this is the trick to repair it, all right? You flip the canvas over, all right? And you can still kind of see it, you can feel it, but it's not like it was. So what you do is get some water, and you wet the back of the canvas, right? And you get a hair dryer, and it shrinks the canvas, and it pulls that made that dimple almost disappear. You can just barely see it. So if that ever happened to you, it's something you can do is, you can see it right barely. Well, you can actually see where something pressed against it right there, but it's not too bad. Okay, well, there you go. We have completed this painting. We're done. All right, thanks for being here once again. And go down in my description below and check out my Patreon site. Find some cool perks. You have a good one. Bye.